and welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to create a grid along with a design, how to manipulate that design, and how to customize it fully by just simply using a few tools. The first thing is we need a grid to keep our design as accurate as possible. So go to Insert, go to Table, click on the drop down, just insert a table. Just click and drag across all of these. It doesn't matter how many you put in. Select the table with the top left square. Go to Layout. Go to Height. And we're going to change the height to 1 centimeter. And we're going to change the width of ourselves again to 1 centimeter and press Enter. Now we have a perfectly square grid. Now I'm just going to center this grid. So go to Home, Center. And now what we can use this grid for is to draw out any design we want to, and I'll show you a few tips and tricks you need to enable you to do this as accurately as possible. And now go up to Insert, go to Shapes, click on the drop down, and go to this shape here. It's really important that you use the freeform shape and just click. So I'm going to click on the corner of one of these squares and then hold down my Shift key. That will ensure that any line I now draw will be perfectly horizontal, vertical, or at a 45 degree angle. And no matter where I put my cursor, it will only take me to those three angles. So I'm going to move my cursor across. You can draw any shape you want. Now, once you've finished your shape, you can see now that it's a standalone shape. And the great thing about this is that you can now manipulate it. So I'm going to select it. I'm going to go up to the top here and select No Outline, because there's an outline around your shape. Go to Shape Fill and I'm going to use black. The reason I'm choosing black is because most logos are in black, but do feel free to change the color on this. You can go to Shape Fill. There's an abundance of colors here, or go to More Fill Colors. And you can select from your color wheel by dragging this cursor around here or selecting from the top here. The color of choice will be selected here and just click OK. I'm just going to choose black for now. And I'm going to move this down the page. And if we use these squares around the outside, we can now completely manipulate this shape. And you can be quite diverse with it to create some really interesting shapes depending on how you move this around. So I'm going to choose this shape here, and now I'm going to copy and paste it by clicking on it and then holding down my Alt or Option key, clicking and dragging. Then I'm going to select one of them. Then I'm going to hold down my Shift key so it maintains its ratio. And I'm going to pull it out and I'm going to put it on the top of this one. And then I'm going to line up the bottom of it. And now I'm going to select them both by holding down my Command or Control key and clicking on both of the shapes. Then going to Align, click on the drop down and select Align to Center. And that will ensure that this shape is perfectly lined up with the center of the larger shape. Now go up to Group, click on the drop down and select Group. Now this is all one shape. Again, we can use the squares at the edge to manipulate this shape into any shape we want. Once we've done that, we've got a number of options. I'm going to click and drag out another shape. So now this is all one shape. You can now hold down your Alt or Option key, click and drag, or just do copy and paste. Then I'm going to select this shape and I'm actually going to turn it all the way around to 180 degrees. Now I can join this shape up to the other shape. I can pull it away, but I am going to center it to this shape. So again, I select one of them, hold down my Command or Control key and select the other one. Go to Shape Format, Align, click on the drop down and align to center. And once again, these shapes are perfectly lined up. I'm going to go to Group and select Group. Now this is one shape. And once again, we can manipulate the shape by using all of the boxes around the outside until it looks exactly the way we want it. Alternatively, you can play around. If you copy and paste this shape, you can actually ungroup it, select it, ungroup it. You can then take this one and actually move it above the other one like this. Once again, select them both and just line them up to the center. And then you can use your arrow keys to move this up and down and see what other shapes you can create from your original shape. And then once again, you can select them both, go to group, select group, and once again, you can completely manipulate these shapes and designs. Once you've completed your designs, all you need to do is right click, go down to save as picture, and when you do, it's really important that you save it as a PNG. If you don't, you're going to get a white background, so if you put this logo onto any colored background, it's going to have a white square in the background. So save it as a PNG, save it to whichever file you like and the name, and then just click save. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.